In this video, we're going to address the question of what are examples of compensation when you're injured on the job in California? My name is Matt Eason. I've been practicing workers' compensation and personal injury related law for over 25 years. And in this video, we're going to address the basic forms or examples of compensation that you can expect in the workers' compensation system in California. Under California's workers' compensation system, there are four basic types of benefits that you're entitled to as compensation if you've suffered an on-the-job injury. The first type of compensation that you're entitled to under California's workers' compensation system is really better characterized as a benefit than as compensation. That benefit that you're entitled to is all of your medical care reasonably necessary for your injury. The reason why it's characterized as a benefit instead of compensation is in workers' compensation, you do not have to pay upfront for your care. The employer has to pay that care directly as a benefit. That's different than in the personal injury world, where you have to seek your own medical care and then you have to seek then compensation for that care after the fact to get reimbursed. The second type of compensation we usually address in the workers' compensation system has to do with temporary disability benefits. You are entitled to temporary disability benefits if you're off work for 3 or more days. In some situations, you're entitled to temporary disability benefits right away. Those benefits are historically 2/3 of your average weekly earnings until you can return to work, whether it's full duty or with modified duty. There is, unfortunately, a time limit when those benefits will run out, which is usually 104 cumulative weeks. If you get to the end of the 104 cumulative weeks, then often Social Security or a different type of state benefit does kick in. The third benefit that we talk about in the workers' compensation is generally referred to as permanent disability benefits. Permanent disability benefits are a calculation of your overall disability using objective factors such as lifting, bending, stooping, 10 minutes, 10 pounds, sometimes, always, never. Those type of factors go into a formula that then determines your rating, and that rating goes into another formula that then determines the amount of benefits you're entitled to for your permanent disability. Unfortunately, one of the things you didn't hear in that calculation was pain and suffering. With a rare exception, workers' compensation really doesn't take into account pain and suffering for most disability ratings. The last standard compensation that we deal with a workers' compensation claim has to do with vocational rehabilitation rights. If you find yourself in a situation where your lifelong limitations are such that you cannot return to your prior occupation, then there's a vocational voucher that you may be entitled to that helps you towards retraining or finding a new job. So again, the four basic types of compensation that you're entitled to in the workers' compensation system have to do with medical care, temporary disability, permanent disability, and vocational rehabilitation. There are other situations that you might be entitled to benefits when the injury was caused by the serious and willful misconduct of your employer. There's a penalty that might apply that you might want to speak to an attorney about. Or if you've been discriminated against, you may have what's known as a 132A violation named after a labor code. If you have any questions about your rights to workers' compensation benefits here in California, I hope you'll consider reaching out to myself or one of the other attorneys in our firm. My name again was Matt Eason. The firm name is Eason and Tambornini. We're located at 1234 H Street, Sacramento, California, 95814. Our phone number is 916-438-1819. And you can find us on the web at www.capcitylaw.com.